Hi guys, and welcome to episode 1 of the Iron Man Challenge. So, as we discussed before, the Iron Man Challenge is to try and get to max level in World of Warcraft without ever dying or equipping any items beyond white quality. So, why aren't my nameplates working? That's because it's a critter. Ah, it's a great start to the day. So guys, if you couldn't work it out from that, while I am a bit of a WoW... Well, I was going to say expert, but we'll call it veteran. A WoW veteran. Haven't played in an extremely long time.
Farewell.
So, we could be a little bit rusty, and I thought the best way to get back into this challenge, back into this game, is with the challenge that is deemed to be the most difficult leveling challenge that there is. You know, why not bite off more than you can chew straight from the beginning, eh? And... how on earth can they not have made auto loot on by default by now? So, the aim for this challenge is to get to max level. I am realistic. I'm aiming to make an entertaining video. If I get to max level, fantastic. But I think the best way to go about this is to try and set yourself realistic goals along the way, little sub goals. So, today's hopeful goal is to reach level 10. Ideally, get ourselves a new pet, because pets are, well, spiders, they suck. It's as simple as that. I don't even really care what I get ourselves as a new pet today, providing it's not a spider. This is starting to get irritating, however, with the lack of music. What's going on here? The audio seems to be cutting out. Let's try this again. Okay guys, we seem to have fixed the audio, but it has been periodically cutting out. We'll have another look into that in a little while when we can figure out why that's happened. And there's level 2 guys, see? The challenge. It's easy, right? That's what people keep telling us. Yeah, if you hadn't guessed, I've never leveled an undead before, so all these quests are brand new to me. If I end up making a fool of myself, please do not take it too harsh out on me. I may cry. But, yeah. Please don't be mean. Don't know where my spider's gone. See, this is why we hate him. Where is he? Where is he already? He's just chilling out back here. Look at the mail. Oh, he's gone. We no longer have a spider. Let's get him back with us, I think. He may be useless, but he's the best we've got. I'm not even going to name him. I don't want to even pretend that I'm going to grow attached to him. If anything, I want to get rid of him. So what's a name that we don't like? What do you call things that you don't like? And you know what? We already have a name, don't we? He's already established his name. Useless. Where's Useless? There he is. One quest down. So it's nice to know that there are little wolves here, so we have a wolf as an option when we get to level 10, guys. That's one way we could go. Every time I play this game, I realise how much I've missed it. It's such an excellent game. For anyone who's never played this game, while I wouldn't recommend the first thing you attempt doing is the Iron Man Challenge, I would highly recommend this game. It is, well, I started playing it about 11-12 years ago, and I'm still playing it now. It's that excellent that it's just transcendent of time. It is a fantastic game, even if you're used to games that are more modern with a bit better graphical quality. The storytelling alone in this game is just second to none. Absolutely second to none. And the depth of the story itself as well. It's mind-boggling. I think I once read somewhere, I can't confirm this for you, but I believe if you got all the quest text, this stuff here, and put it back to back, it's actually the same as 130 copies of Lord of the Rings, which for those of you who don't know is a pretty big book. Kind of wish I'd installed some form of damage tracking add-on so I could see what kind of effect that undead passive is actually having for us. Hello. That might be something that we look into for next time. Can I go on the log? Actually. It's not like we're going to see what's going on in the chat, so keep this log rolling. Touch of the Grave. Hit for 6 damage. We're only hitting for... Cobra Shot's only hitting for 20. That's pretty substantial, this level. Heal for 0, 6 overheal, because obviously we're at full health. The pet is tanking everything for us. Not quite as useless as we might have made out, eh? See? One little star. But it's nice to know that we have that, that little bit of a backup there as well in the form of our passive. Oh, we have Concussive Shot. I really need to have my buttons immediately go on my bars. That's one of the downsides of LVY. If you're not familiar with the add-on I'm using, guys, it's LVY that gives us this sort of appearance for the game. This is not the Blizzard standard UI. And it's fantastic. Honestly, there is just... it's perfect in every way. I should put more effort into actually configuring everything before we begin. I don't think I'm going to cannibalize on a button. It's not like whether we use it. Same with Culpet and Revive Pet, we will give a key bind to. But yeah, the big failing, in my opinion, of LVY is that your buttons don't automatically go on as you level. It's probably a setting that you can change for it. That's the thing that's the best thing about this UI. It is so configurable. And while I haven't played in a while, I'm normally a bit of an add-on whore. I would literally have hundreds of add-ons at any one time. But I wanted to start streaming. Basically, I've got the opportunity to do so. Streaming. Recording. I knew what I meant. Streaming could be down the line. But anyway, I wanted to get back into playing WoW and getting this series started. And I couldn't be bothered to go through the hundreds of add-ons back to where I was. I wouldn't even remember most of them or what they were there for. And I sat there for a while and I thought, well, what do I really need? What's the actual requirement for me to play the game? And for me, it's LVY. It's entirely just this add-on. It does everything that you actually require. There's plenty of other things it doesn't do that are nice, but just gives it so much more of a streamlined feel to the game. Just realised as well that does sound as though I'm suggesting that Blizzard's UI is bad. It's not. If you are brand new to the game, that is actually what I would recommend while you learn the game. It is fantastic. It's just not quite as sleek. So yes, the rules of the Iron Man Challenge. That reminded me, pet battling, that is another one of the things that is off the table, guys. I will put a link in the description for all of the rules in detail. But basically, anything that you can do that gets you experience beyond questing and killing is off the table. Even some forms of those are, for example, dungeons are not allowed, guys. You cannot group with anybody, which kind of offsets your capacity to do the dungeons, but they're actually banned by the rules anyway, even if you found a way of soloing them. Similarly, pet battles are off limits, professions are off limits, anything that gets you experience outside of the general quests. I wonder how we're doing. It's kind of hard to tell in this UI as it stands at the minute for what levels I am at. So let's have a quick look. I'm at level 4 already. Ooh, the Iron Lamb with the Patient. The Patient is really the only one I have on this account. So for those of you who don't know, again, I have quite a lot of accounts. I can think of at least 4 off the top of my head. And apparently, the best title I have available at level 4 on this account is the Patient, which is quite disappointing. Feel a bit harsh sending my pet spider to go and kill what is probably his siblings. But then again, he's a spider and he deserves it. Definitely killing more than I need to be killing. These are still pretty low level quests and I'm now getting to be nearly level 5. Oh, there is level 5. Did I get a new ability? No, I did not. When do I get a new ability? Wait, have I genuinely got no ability to get back my focus? Because if so, that is heartbreaking. So yeah, guys, if anyone's watching other Iron Man series simultaneously with this one, you may notice that there are a few differences to what I'm telling you. So the Iron Man Challenge was incredibly popular back in Warlords of Draenor because of the fact that the game, well, it got a bit dull, essentially. The content did not come out as quickly as people were able to complete it, and people were left with extended periods of time wanting to play the game but without any sort of endgame content that they were looking to do. And as such, they did things like leveling alts, and the challenge rose to popularity. That being said, however, the game changed a lot when Legion came out. So while it has also had a slight decline in popularity, the challenge, I'm sure it'll re-spark as soon as Legion's content becomes a bit more dull and heavily completed. But the biggest change is actually in the gameplay. So you are not allowed to take talents. You've never been allowed to take talents in the Iron Man Challenge. However, you are now allowed to have a spec and change your spec. This is because when Legion launched, you lost the ability to not have a spec. When you make your character at level 1, it will have a spec. I believe as a hunter, it defaults to putting you as Beastmaster. Let's have a quick look. Why am I clicking when I know the commands? Yeah, see, so you are Beastmaster by default. You are allowed to have a spec now, as a result, because obviously you can't make a character without, but you are also allowed to change your specs. Your specs are interchangeable, but you still cannot take talents. So if any of you are wondering why I have a spec when other people who did this previously did not, that is why. They will have filmed it pre-Legion. Just going to continue to work our way through here. I know the quest is completed, but I'm hopeful of a treasure chest or a boss mob or a rare or something in here that's clearly not here. It was a waste of time. Oh, Nightweb Matriarch. Probably going to get a quest to come back and fight her in a minute now that I've killed her, but... oh well, what are you going to do? Oh, have we found our first hostile mobs? I think we have. First opportunity for death right here. But I'm gonna go out on a limb and say it's a pretty small chance. It'd be rather embarrassing if I died on episode 1 of the challenge prior to getting to level 10, which is the point when you can get your character tracked.
I don't have
on the system. So. I would not like that at all. That would make me feel like a colossal idiot. I was thinking about getting the add-on for auto-turning. Given to understand that there isn't a form of add-on that breaks the rules, we'll have to check that. But auto-turning would allow us to both pick up and hand in quests instantaneously. But I think we're going to, when we get to a zone that's a little bit more interesting. Than most of the starting zones, which are quite frankly terrible. Well, terrible in terms of storytelling, not terrible in terms of design. And then we'll actually be able to read them because we'll be taking our time a little bit more. But at this point, the challenge isn't really a challenge. The challenge comes with the scaling, so we're able to sort of just fly through the zone. So while we can, we should. We really want to get that level 10. Trying to decide what spec we're going to go with. Well, I said that you can change your specs, guys, in the rules. The actual game itself doesn't allow you to do so until level 10, I do believe. So, currently trying to decide whether we'll be sticking with Beastmaster. Oh, we'll save this guy. Look at us being good guys. So good we can do the challenge while saving people. Anyway, yeah, we are deciding whether we want to change from Beast Mastery to either survival or marksmanship. Now, I don't know an awful lot about hunters. I know practically nothing about hunters. But what I do know is that Beast Mastery is simple, and obviously by its name, it is the pet orientated spec.
I need a target.
So, your pet is doing a lot of the heavy lifting. Like I've said before, that is why we pick hunter. The pet is going to be tanking, he's going to be taunting, some pets can even do some forms of CC. They're going to be incredibly useful, so I think Beast Mastery is the way to go. But I don't know what utility the other specs have as well, but I do believe you can now change pretty freely between them all. And given that we don't have to worry about stat optimization because we don't have any stats, we can pretty much sort of change as and when we please to fit the needs of what we're doing. So maybe we can be everything. That'd be nice. Oh, hello person. Thanks. We will not be dueling you. Not a chance, my friend. Oops. Oh, now this is a mistake you don't want to make, guys. Every copper is worth something when you are doing the Iron Man challenge, so if you've had to throw things away, You are not optimized. And as a result right now, I think what we're going to do is we're going to run back, hand in the quest that we have done, and we're going to sell up all of these items we have in that bag. Also, guys, pretty stupid move back there, being that zoomed in. You will get snuck up on. Patrols are lethal. This is a scary building to be entering. Quite terrified, not only of possible enemies at any point and nowhere to run, but also that's a long way down. Well, it will be when we get to the top. I mean, I am the type of clumsy person that can definitely fall and kill himself while on the Iron Man drone. That is entirely something I am capable of.
Yes.
Ooh, Lillian.
Embrace the shadow.
Oh god. He's level 15. You ready to run? You ready to run? Do we have to kill him? I want to keep backing up, but that's very close to the edge. Oh, a rare! Always kill the rares on the challenge, guys. The rares. What's going on there? Where's he going? Oh, okay. That makes sense. Well, we can head down there now anyway, so. Oh, no. Well, maybe we will give up on the rare. Boingy boingy. See, now this is the type of quest that's actually more deceptively problematic than most of them. Simply because these are on the cliff edge. Cliffs are steep. Fall damage is savage. So this is one of the perks of being the undead. I hate these underwater quests, and it doesn't make it any better, but what it does do is it removes the inability to breathe underwater. We have the ability to breathe underwater. Well, I say that we do. I think it actually, in the story sense, is meant to be that the undead don't require to breathe. Whatever way, we aren't currently suffering one of the breath bars up here that I'm sure you're familiar with from the game. That is just one of the little perks of being an undead. One of the downsides of being an undead in the water is that ridiculous swimming animation. What is that? How does that work? I actually work at a swimming pool in real life at the moment, and I can assure you, while we've had some truly terrible swimmers, no one has ever been able to propel themselves while side on, moving their legs in a... Well, I don't even know how to describe that motion, but we'll go with paw. Wow, the way the spider's legs dangle when he's in the water, it's really, really creepy. Almost as bad as that movement animation. That was, what is that? It's like he's headbutting the ground repeatedly.
I'm listening.
Pumpkin bag.
Victory.
We got a bag. Ooh, guys. Getting bags. It's exciting stuff. We also got some gloves, but I mean, that's far less exciting. Quests! I don't feel right. Oh wow! Well, sucks to be that guy. Wait, are we the bad guys? I mean, I know we're the Horde, but... Yeah. I suppose bad's subjective. Well, evil is subjective. This time, guys, we're going to get ourselves this vile fin, and we're going to walk back, taking no chances whatsoever. Oh, apart from possibly killing him, there's a chance of that. Oh, there we go. We've got him, guys. We've got our vile fin. and now he's following us. And you know what we're going to do, guys? We're going to put a skull on his head so we can easily spot him, and then get some screen bleeding. This way we'll know if he gets into any trouble if anything tries to eat him, because he is pretty tasty looking compared to most of the things around. I mean, he looks like a slightly strange fish, which I think I would rather eat over the rats that are around, or the bats for that matter. Come on, you little bastard. There we go.
I'm listening.
All that for that. Well, that was disappointing. Oh well. Oh. Oh, is that a... We found a rare, guys. And this one is not high enough that we can't get it. If we can kill it, on the other hand, is an entirely different matter. I'm not entirely sure how challenging it's going to be. I hope we're still at the point of the game where it's going to be pathetically easy. But that will be transitioning out fairly soon. Oh, it's not pathetically easy, but it seems that it is going to be doable. It's the point where I'd love to show you all of the advanced gameplay that you could use at this point, but with this few buttons, you're pretty much just shooting things. But there we go, that is why you kill the rares, guys. That was a massive amount of experience. And a green iron, my first one. So guys, when we're talking about the qualities and the rules for the Iron Man's, green is the quality that comes after the white, and should I equip that right now, I would fail the challenge. You can pick them up in your bag, you can sell them to the shop. I do believe you can even sell them on the auction house if you so desire, but you cannot equip it. Once you've equipped it, your statistics page will show that you've equipped a green or better item, and then you will automatically fail the challenge.
This better be good.
I have no idea what they're making in this, but I don't like that it has what appear to be little shower nozzles on the end of it. I don't think I'd like to have a shower in whatever that is. We'll give that a miss. Time to go to my least favourite city in the whole game. If you can navigate Undercity, there is something wrong with your brain. Pretty sure I'm going to cut that flight out that we just saw, as it got me dizzy just turning.
Glory
that many times.
To the Sindorai.
Damn unfair. Not sure how far we can go with this questline before we would get things like buffs that are against the rules of the challenge and things, so we're just going to decline
Shurelo
it.
Run.
If we miss it entirely, we're definitely safe.
Speak quickly. Beware. Forsaken. Farewell.
About right to
be
Brill.
Quick about your business.
Gonna get rid of that because I'm scared having it in my bag.
Remember, patience. Discipline. Why would you ask our death?
Back to Brill.
Out.
This is the way Undercity is meant to be done. On the back of a flight path where you don't have to worry about navigating it because the game does it for you. Fantastic. First aid. That's what we want. First aid training. Guys, we learned first aid training. That stuff looks expensive. Let's give that a miss.
This had better be good. Watch your back.
Disengage? Ooh, I didn't realize we had disengage. It's control one. Innkeeper, guys, do not forget to set your inn to where you want your hearthstone to be. There is no worse feeling than hearthstoning back before where you started. It's horrible. Oh my god, it's a stealth mob! That's terrifying. It's not actually even attacking. What just happened? Oh, okay. That was absolutely shit scary. I thought I was dead. There. Oh God, no, no, no. God, I thought I could kill it. Damn you. Is that, that's the rare. The rare's back, guys.
I don't have a target.
Quite tempted to farm this rare if he's gonna spawn that quickly. Either that or I've been playing a lot longer than I thought I had. And now I'm scared because he's on me. Oh, that was the worst disengage of all time. Spider, help! Stop being useless! Oh my god, that was terrifying. That is not the way to do that. Oh my. The experience was nice though. That leap was hilarious. See guys, this is what I'm on about. Two mobs, one blood. What the hell? Did the other one just not have blood? Was he that far gone? Some sort of undead dog that he didn't even need blood anymore? Oh my god, Fireball. He's ranged. Ah!
I don't have a target.
There's the memorandum.
Too far away.
There's the zealot. Oh god, there's a captain something.
I need a target.
Help! Help! Spider, help! Useless.
I don't have a target.
Finally, it only took like a million balls. Balls? Wow. It's taken that many of these dogs that I forgot what's a dog and what's a ball. My brain has died. Just like my will to kill these dogs. We should tame the dog. We should tame the dog. I've decided if they're that badass, they don't even give up their blood when they die. That's what you want to shop at. That is what you want. So guys, that quest did just give us these weak trolls blood elixirs. Elixirs are banned. Do not accidentally click one of these or your Iron Man challenge is over. So we're not even going to risk it. We're not even going to go and sell them. I'm too scared that we'll accidentally click them. There they go. They're gone. Not worth it, guys. Fool. Sorry. I want more buttons! Ooh, look guys, it's a copper vein. And that's as much use on this challenge as that is to us. We can look at it. Look how pretty it looks, guys. It's shining. Does it even shine? Is it shining? I can't even tell. Oh yeah, it's got this little yellow glow. You know, just like copper does in real life. I've taught me seeing little copper coins and stuff till it just start emanating light. It's totally how it works. This is an empty forest. I don't know if I was the wildlife that lives in like the next zones, but I'd probably come for a wander through here. Like, you could have all the room in the world. Real estate. There's plenty of it. No. See, grr fresh meat to me does not sound like an intelligent animal. Kinda sounds like that guy from The Lord of the Rings, if I'm honest with you. Yeah, why can't we have some meat? many Murlocs? Does that mean playable Murlocs? That is the dream. Playable Murlocs is the dream.
Get closer.
Chase them until they pass out. That sounds horrible. Oh, wow. That is absolutely horrible. And hilarious.